Hello, my name is Sonia Rome. I'm a hospitalist and a well-being champion for the Utah chapter of the ACP. We have all been on a terribly difficult journey since the pandemic started. I want to share how doubling down on compassion helped me get through some very difficult moments when I wondered how I was going to hold on to my humanity. Last winter, the week after Christmas, I picked up a very busy inpatient service. Despite making the right treatment decisions, our team had 4 patients pass away. It was hard. We could make the right decisions, but still end up with a painful outcome. It felt like part of me was screaming to run away from that hurt. But it led me to try to redefine what is at the center of patient care, what really truly matters. And I ended up re-exploring compassion, which was a good way forward. We have all experienced compassion, but breaking it down can help us understand its power. The literal meaning of the word is suffering with. Neuroscience has described it as a distinct state of our brains. We're wired for it. There are many teachers and practices, but it can be primarily broken down into 3 key components. The first is making a connection with another person around our unique human experiences. The second is recognizing that other person's suffering. And third is having the intent, taking a small action, a big action, to see if you can alleviate that suffering. Understanding the concept at a fundamental level will help us practice it. First of all, I want to point out, it intentionally releases us from the outcome because it is the intent, it is the trying to alleviate suffering that is valued. Partly because we only have control over our own actions, but also to be human is to recognize we can't alleviate all suffering. The other important part of the definition is that in order to be compassionate, we have to recognize suffering. On a flip side, it means that our really hard moments where we ourselves are suffering, they can be transformed into fuel to recognize a greater depth of suffering in the future. And finally, the first step of compassion involves connection with our fellow human beings. This is often a driving factor for why we have pursued our roles in medicine. It can be a great source of joy, and especially when you start to seek it out on an intentional basis. Practicing compassion with others is great, but it's also important for ourselves. Self-compassion is not self-indulgence, not self-pity. It's not letting yourself off the hook. But if we apply the same components, it means we get to be human. We get to make mistakes. We allow ourselves to recognize our own suffering. We give ourselves just a little bit of grace to alleviate it. In those dark winter months last year, I doubled down. I tried to make more connections, recognize suffering, and having some intent to alleviate it. It is a muscle that requires practice, but I think it's well worth it. I hope you consider exploring compassion as a way to move forward through difficult times. There are many resources to help you get started. I encourage you to check out the Resource Hub on I Am Wellbeing, as well as physician advocacy work, which is a form of compassion from ACP. Thank you.